Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to talk about government schemes, MCQs and explanations. Now government schemes, as you all must be aware, hold a lot of importance for the upcoming RBI and SEBI, both examinations. And despite revising it a lot of times with students providing the summary sheet of government schemes through flashcards, despite doing all that, a lot of students are still confused and still want me to cover government schemes through as many MCQs as possible. And therefore, this lesson, wherein I'm going to be creating a total of 5 sessions in this series on government schemes, and I will be picking up some important MCQs, and I will also be explaining the concepts behind them, all the amendments or acts or schemes involved behind them. Okay. So let us start without wasting any time. I'll be taking up 5 questions in the first lesson, and we will move forward and cover a total of 5 sessions in this series, after which I will start with something else for the upcoming RBI and SEBI examination. Okay. So the first question is, the Maternity Benefit Act 1961 was amended in 2017. So because it was amended very recently, therefore it becomes important. Okay. So this was amended in the year 2017 to increase the maternity leave period to dash from the previous 12 weeks for a woman employee for the first 2 children. What is the new maternity leave period? The answer to this question is C, 26 weeks. So it has been increased from 12 weeks to 26 weeks. A little bit about the act, the amendments which have been made. By this amendment, maternity leave period increases to 26 weeks from the previous 12 weeks for a woman employee for the first 2 children. Now, these are the keywords you have to remember. Previous was 12 weeks, new is 26 weeks. How many children? Only the first 2 children. It is aimed to ensure health of women employees pursuant to giving birth and also safety of newborn child. It was done by Ministry of Labour and Employment and not Ministry of Women and Child Development. So, remember this. The ministry which did this was Ministry of Labour and Employment. The second question is related to Aadhaar card amendment. The question is, Aadhaar card bill is amended in July 2019, in which a new clause is inserted regarding the use of Aadhaar card. Which of the following is not among the new clauses? Let's have a look at the clauses mentioned here. Number one, Aadhaar is now voluntary for obtaining mobile phone SIM cards. Second, Aadhaar card is now voluntary for opening bank accounts. Third, Aadhaar can now be used by states for implementation of their schemes by state government. Fourth, any child can exit Aadhaar program on attaining 21 years of age. So these are all the clauses which have been provided here. If you know the answer, provide the answer in the comment section below. Think about it, answer it to yourself, and then see whether you are making a mistake or whether you are prepared significantly or not. First one is correct. Yes, it is now voluntary for mobile phone SIM cards. Second is also correct. You don't need to give Aadhaar for opening a bank account. You can use other documents as well. Third is also correct. It can be used by states for implementing various state schemes. And the fourth one is incorrect for the reason that any child can exit Aadhaar program on attaining 18 years of age and not 21 years of age. Okay. So the correct answer here is 1, 2 and 3 are correct, and fourth one is incorrect, and we have to answer the incorrect one. So which one is not one of the clauses? D, only 4 is not a new clause. Let's have a look at the features of the new Aadhaar as well as the features of the old Aadhaar. So the Aadhaar Act was passed in the year 2016. According to which Aadhaar was declared compulsory for services including bank account, PAN card, cell phone services, passport and even driving licenses. But then the Supreme Court struck it down and the new Aadhaar amendment bill was introduced and passed with the new features that I just mentioned. Aadhaar can now be used by states for implementing their schemes. States can use Aadhaar for devolution of funds through direct benefit transfer. Okay. The new act allows the people to register complaints in certain cases, including impersonation or disclosure of their identity. Whereas the Aadhaar Act, the old one, only allowed courts to take cognizance of an offence. So only courts were allowed to take cognizance of any offence under UIDAI, but now you can register complaints in UIDAI itself. What is the penalty? Penalty is 1 crore and jail term for private entities which end up violating provisions of Aadhaar data. Okay, and children can exit biometric ID program, that is UID program, on attaining 18 years of age. Let's have a look at the third question. Interstate River Water Disputes Amendment Act. This is the area on which the question has been created. Very important, because this Amendment Act has been passed very recently. The question is, the central government approved Interstate River Water Disputes Amendment 2019 over the current Interstate River Water Disputes Act 1956. What is or are correct about amendments among the following? The four options given are: number one, setting up one Interstate River Water Dispute Tribunal with multiple benches. So there will now be one tribunal and multiple benches. Second, the time limit for adjudication of disputes is to be 4.5 years. There was no deadline before. The tenure for services has been laid down to 5 years or attaining the age of 70, whichever is earlier. Earlier there was no limit. Setting up of a dispute resolution committee for amicably resolving interstate water disputes within 18 months. So there might be a any error in the numbers that have been mentioned here. Time limit for adjudication, 4.5 years. Time limit for amicably resolving the dispute, 18 months as per these features that have been provided here. Only one tribunal and multiple benches, and tenure for people who will be a part of tribunal, now 5 years or 70 years, 5 years or attaining the age of 70. So we have to answer which one of the following are correct. The answer is D, 1, 2, 3, 4, all of them are correct. The focus of this question was making you aware about the amendments. That's why all the four options are correct. What are the key features of the bill? The same. To constitute a single tribunal with different benches, earlier there used to be multiple tribunals. To establish dispute resolution committee for resolving disputes within 18 months or 1 year, 6 months. Okay. Adjudication time period, 4.5 years, and age limit for service, 5 years or if you attain the age of 70. The next question is from Indian Forest Act 1927, which has been amended. The question is, amending section 2/7 of Indian Forest Act 1927, dash is no longer a tree, and if it is felled, it is not timber. The answer to this question, yes, is A, bamboo. A, bamboo is no more to be considered a tree. And why is it advantageous? It is advantageous for the bamboo industry, because before this, farmers required permission for cutting bamboo, whatever they were planting bamboo, and also for transmitting, also for transporting bamboo from either one state to the other or within the state from the forest, state forest department. That is now no more required. The fifth and last question for today is, FSSAI, Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, new draft Food Safety and Standard Regulations 2019 announced two food components mandatory to be declared on pre-packaged foods. What are those components? You have to answer that. Please answer it in the comment section below, or keep it to yourself if you want to. Let me have a look at the answer. The answer for this is B, salt and sugar. So now pre-packaged food companies have to make sure that the amount of salt and sugar is declared on their packaged foods, and the purpose is simple: to control diseases like hypertension and diabetes. Okay. So this was about government schemes, as well as the focus was more on new resolutions, new amendments in the acts in this particular session. In the next session, I will be looking at some government schemes and some amendments, some acts which have been amended, some schemes which have been amended recently. The focus is very, very simple: to cover what is most important from examination point of view, so that the chances of these questions or these areas being asked in the examination also increases. If you like this session, if you feel that these sessions are helping you prepare on your own for the upcoming examinations as well. Or if you like these sessions on the whole as well, then do not forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to ensure that you do not miss out on the future videos, because I will keep coming out with more and more sessions on either government schemes or other important areas for the upcoming RBI and SEBI examination. All the very best. Take care.